Interoperability tutorials are interesting because they deal with at least two pieces of software, sometimes more. Here we're looking at bringing together Autodesk Revit and 3ds Max, and in particular 3ds Max Design. For the purposes of this tutorial, I will be using 3ds Max Design because I'm actually running the Autodesk Building Design Ultimate Suite on my system. This suite includes Revit and 3ds Max Design, but also a plethora of other Autodesk applications, which I will not be discussing here. Don't worry if you don't have the suite. Everything I will show you can work equally well with the standalone versions of Revit and 3ds Max Design. In fact, if you have plain old 3ds Max, you can make it look and behave like 3ds Max Design so that following along is a bit easier. For that, you can use the Custom UI and Default Switcher function to set your UI in light mode, as is the default in 3ds Max Design, and also to use Mentor Ray, as is also the default when working in design and visualization. You get a breakdown of how the defaults change, the most important being that Mentor Ray is active by default, and that real-world texture coordinates will be applied when creating materials and applying mapping coordinates. Once you click on Set, the interface changes, but for good measure, you need to exit and restart the application. That's it. From this point on, 3ds Max will look and behave like 3ds Max Design, and you'll have no problems following this tutorial. If you later need to reset 3ds Max to its default look and feel, then you can use the appropriate options to that effect. Again, you will need to restart the application for the changes to take place. In my case, and as I mentioned earlier, I'll be using 3ds Max Design as I record this tutorial, although I may be referring to it simply as 3ds Max. As you may have noticed, 3ds Max and 3ds Max Design can happily coexist on the same system. One thing about interoperability that my experience has shown me is that a user is seldom an expert in both applications. That's okay, because a tutorial such as this one can be beneficial for both the Revit user who wants to use 3ds Max for better rendering and animation, and also for the 3ds Max user who needs to rely on Revit's superior architectural tools for quick and easy building designs. This can also be beneficial for the 3ds Max user who doesn't own Revit, but occasionally gets Revit data from clients and partners. As you go through this tutorial series, you will learn how to make the best of Revit models, even if you don't own Revit. If you do, then that's even better, and you'll have a better experience with this tutorial. There are a few basic principles to remember, though, and they relate to project units. First, let's talk about units in Revit. When you start a new project, you can base it on a template type, and even on a template unit preference, such as imperial or metric. You can also change the display in a way that works for you. What you need to remember, though, is that no matter what unit setup you choose, Revit always exports its data in feet. This is important to remember because it will affect interoperability with 3ds Max. To prevent any scale issues between the two applications, and knowing that Revit always exports in feet, I would suggest that you set up 3ds Max to also work in feet. To adjust units in 3ds Max, you go to Customize, Units Setup. There are two areas to set up your units. The display setup, seen at first, but also the system units setup. The system units setup is the important one here, and that's the one that needs to match Revit. By default, it is set to inches, but you need to set it to feet anytime you work on interoperability between the two applications. An inch-based unit is fine to design small objects, but working in feet usually works better for architectural structures anyway. This takes you back to the display units. These are set to generic by default, but you can choose to set them to metric or imperial, whichever you are more comfortable with. Unit setup will remain active until you change it again, even after closing the application. If you are interested in more detail about units, as they relate to sharing data, There is a tutorial on this channel that explores these issues in depth. With these basic principles in check, watch the next movie to learn about the various ways to export data from Revit to 3ds Max.